Happy Thursday.
Happy Thursday.
How you doing today?
Pretty good. It's been a long week, so I'm glad it's toward the end of it.
Yeah. I hear you on that. How's your body feeling?
My knee's a little bit stiff, but otherwise I feel pretty good.
Yeah.
I've been eating very lightly lately, and I feel lighter.
That's a good feeling, isn't
That's
it?
That's a good feeling, isn't it?
Yeah, definitely.
Right. Just letting that weight
come off. Yeah. Right.
Your body.
Exactly.
Virgo seat. Right. Nonetheless, we have to take care of ourselves and do the work. So I'm very proud of you for showing up.
Thank you.
Started in a little bit. Any specific areas you want to focus on today?
My legs were a little bit, like my thighs were a little bit sore after last weekend. Mm-hmm. I've done a little bit of stretching this week, but not too much.
Okay. So we can hold the position for a little bit longer. Really dive deep into the roots.
Yeah.
Okay, good. And it's also good. A lot of change happening. This is like your roots, if you think about it. So they're sensitive to everything going on, and that could affect your lower back, your legs. So we'll pay some mind and put some energy into those legs.
Yes, thank you.
You're welcome. I'll get started in a little bit. We'll get started in a nice comfortable seated position, allowing the tailbone to be firmly on the earth as you extend your spine from your tailbone all the way up your spine to the top of your head, allowing a nice straight posture, shoulders down away from your ears, placing the palms on top of the knees, facing up towards the sky. Taking a moment to unclench your jaw, relax the shoulders, and just take a nice deep breath in through your nose, expanding your belly, expanding the body, filling up with the present moment, and exhaling completely out from your mouth. Allowing the body to soften. Inhaling in through your nose, full body extension on this breath. For 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, hold. And release slowly out from the mouth, allowing the shoulders, the jaw, fingers, the entire body to just sit in this space and be still and know as you arrive to this reality in this moment that we're in, nothing else matters, not the past nor the future. It's just right here and right now in this moment of eternity. We breathe in love and peace. Filling up your own body, filling up your mind, filling up your heart, and exhaling peace and love into the world, into the space around you. With your awareness on the breath, bring the focus to your heart center. Allow an intention to come for your practice today. Something your heart is seeking, something that your heart can give this practice to, whatever it might be, but this will drive your practice from the beginning until the end. Taking a few more breaths, just scanning the body from the top of your head down the back of the eyes. And if there are any thoughts or distractions, simply come back to your body scan, scanning the back of your neck, your ears, down the shoulders, your arms, your fingers, the chest, all around your heart, your belly, your hips, down to the soles of your feet, allowing your mind to quiet each thought as you come back to your breath, scanning the body, returning home to where we are right now. Become aware if there's any moments or spaces in the body that you feel any tension or stiffness, any energy that has been built up over time. Now is the time to bring your breath and your awareness to the specific area or areas. Taking the breath there, bringing the breath directly to the stiff energy. And on the exhale, release that energy. It becomes looser and free. Take a few moments to access the different points, bringing the breath right where you need it, and then let it all go out from the mouth. Loosen those tight spaces with your breath and return to the fingers. Allow the fingers to gently begin to wiggle, bringing the awareness back to your physical body. Wiggling those fingers. We're going to stretch our arms out wide. We'll begin our practice, gently bringing our arms up over our head, reaching, placing our palms together. Exhale, palms to the center of your chest, shoulders relaxed. Take a moment here to ground and center. Connection of the heart, space, mind, body, spirit, all aligned. Interlacing the fingers, push the palms away from you. Inhale, arms up over the head, arms to the sides of the ears, chest open and forward. Exhale, slightly and gently come down, bringing the arms all the way down to the ground, chin to your chest. Exhale all the way out. Inhale, forward and up, taking the spine all the way to the bottom and then to the top. Good. And then roll those arms down gently, bringing the belly button back, chin to your chest, shoulders down. Exhale all the way out. And inhale, last one, pushing forward and then up. Now we're going to release the fingertips, bring the left fingers to the right knee, and the right hand goes up and then back towards the body in the center of the spine. Fingers or palms of your hands can touch. You want to use your left hand to pivot, pushing up and over the right shoulder. Deep breath in. Exhale all the way out. Two more, inhaling through your nose. Exhaling out from your mouth. Push a little bit deeper. See if you can extend that twist as you find space. And release. Come back to center. Good work. Next, we're going to lift our arms up again, reaching. Nice long stretch and then twist. Right hand goes on the left knee and the left hand back towards the back of the body, twisting up and over the right shoulder. Really twist into it. So take your time. Use the right hand to stretch over the left knee, bringing the gaze up and over the left shoulder. And gently return back. Nice deep breath in, long breath out. And we're just gonna start with our neck, taking our right ear over the right shoulder, rolling your neck back and over to the left, and slowly, gently bring it down. Completing the circle. Inhaling as you go back. Exhaling as you go forward. Take one more in this direction. Exhale down. Take a moment, chin to your chest. Deep breath in. Exhale, begin by bringing the left ear over the left shoulder, rounding the neck backwards. Right ear over the right shoulder. Exhale down. You might be aware that there will be a sweet spot, and it's okay to stay in that spot, in that space that feels good for you. And take your time and just kind of rock the neck in that space. And just rounding the neck, just letting those nerves, the throat, the ears, especially the throat. And now when you're ready, allow the neck just to fall back towards the back of the body, stretching the throat. Deep breath in through your nose. Exhale, bring the chin to your chest. Inhale, round the neck back up towards the back of the body. Inhale, here you can stretch out your tongue. Go close the jaw. Exhale, chin to your chest. And one more of those. Inhaling up. Closing the jaw. Exhale down, chin to your chest. Good. Arrive back up to center. Now we're going to do side to side, gazing up over the left shoulder and then over the right shoulder. Right, and this is a good time to just honor the word no. That no is a complete sentence. Sometimes just no is no. So just take a moment and really stretching your neck from one side to the other. And arrive back to center. We'll get to our shoulders. Bring our shoulder blades up towards our ears. Exhaling them back and down. Inhaling them up. Exhaling. On the exhale, you want to get rid of the weight that you feel on your shoulders. Now is the time to mindfully let that go. We don't have to carry the world. It's a great time to intentionally let go of what's weighing you down, what's weighing on your mind, what's weighing on your body, your heart. Just take that weight right off your shoulders, literally and figuratively. Inhaling up through your nose. Exhaling back and down, far away from your ears. One more. Good. Now we're just going to change directions. Bring the shoulder blades up and forward. It's all about the balance. Good. Two more this direction. Inhaling up, exhaling down. And the last two, you're going to actually place your right hand on the mat, and you're going to walk your right fingertips out towards the side of the body until you feel resistance. And when you do, just place your palm down. And we're going to lift, reach up with our left hand, reaching our arm out straight over our head. Nice deep stretch from your left fingertips all the way down to your left hip. Breathing in deeply into your hips, expanding all of that spine. Exhale, release. On your exhale, you might find extra space because that's what happens when we let go. So reach a little bit deeper, deepen that stretch all the way from the fingertips down to your hips. Breathe into it. One more breath on this side. On the exhale, you're going to push with your right hand and windmill the arms over to the left side, reaching up and over with your right arm. Breathing in into the right hip, keeping the right hip on the mat. It may want to lift, but with your breath, bring it down. Or come up just a little bit on the fingers, whatever feels good for you. Deep breath in. Exhale, come back to center. Good work. Now we're come on to our hips. So placing the body towards the right side, rounding the belly button back and down, coming over to the left. Forward, keeping that chest open. Beautiful. Yep. And just find your circle. Find what you need. If you come across a spot that feels good, you can stay. Breathe into it. And just rounding, opening up the hips, massaging the lower back. You might even feel it in your neck and your knees. It's a full body. So embrace it and breathe into the body, and you can go as deep or as lightly as you would like. And last one, we'll hang out with the chest open in the front for a moment and then switch direction, bringing the torso right over the left knee, up and over the right. Beautiful. Enjoy your own speed. Breathe as you go, breathe in as you go back, exhale as you go forward. Take a few moments. You can close your eyes. Very good. Last one. We'll bring our chest forward, place our hands on our mat, and come up into our tabletop position. If your knees are sore, you can double up on your mat simply by bending it or placing a pillow there. So just see what you need and how it feels. If it feels good as is, just simply place your hands right underneath your elbows, directly underneath your shoulders. Nice straight line, keeping the knees underneath your hips. Toes flat on the mat, beautiful tabletop. Pushing the tailbone up towards the sky to really allow that lower back to feel this massage. Gazing forward, take a deep breath in through the nose. On the exhale, push through the palms of the hands into your shoulders, round the spine, chin to your chest, release into a cat position. And exhale, release, drop the belly, tailbone goes back up into our starting position. They call this cow. Good. So we'll do this a few times, bringing it all the way up and in, squeezing at the top. And then exhale, release it, let it go. Drop the belly, tailbone up, gaze forward. Two more. Inhaling up, squeezing at the top, bringing the tailbone in, squeezing the chin to the chest. And release all the way down, tailbone up. Good work. One more, inhaling as you go in. Exhale, drop the belly, tailbone up, gaze forward. Good. And here we're going to keep our left hand on the mat, inhale, right arm up. Thread the needle, which means bringing the right hand through the center of the body, all the way down onto the right shoulder. Left hand extends forward up towards the front of your mat, relaxing completely on the right shoulder. Allow your fingers to soften. Trust the mat. And with the left hand extended up towards the sky to deepen the stretch in the shoulder blade, bending at the left elbow, twisting up and over the right left shoulder. Good work. And just breathe here for three deep breaths. Opening up the shoulder, the hips. Just be completely present with your physical body. Breathing in, expanding. And then exhale, releasing, right? That exchange that we're in all the time, the give and the take, the give and the take. And when you're ready, bring that left arm up, back up towards the sky, placing the left palm firmly on your mat. Gently push with the left hand up, slowly bringing the right arm through the body, back up towards the sky, and then exhale back into a tabletop position. Good job. Do the same thing on the other side. So right hand firmly placed on the mat. Extending the left arm up towards the sky. Exhale, release. Bring the left hand all the way through underneath the right shoulder. Relax the left hand gently on the mat. Reach with your right arm for a nice deep stretch. Nice. Take another breath here. And to get the shoulder blade, let's extend our arms up towards the sky, bending at the right elbow, tucking the right fingertips into the right left thigh. Reach back with the shoulder, gaze up and over the right shoulder. Inhaling, right arm up. Exhaling onto your mat. Place the left, right hand firmly onto your mat. Use the right hand to push up gently, bringing the left arm all the way up. Exhale back into a tabletop position. Good work. And now if you need to kind of stretch that lower back, you can move the tailbone. And we'll go into our first downward facing dog of the day. So we'll tuck our toes onto the mat. Good. Come into that tabletop. And then into a plank. So gently coming into a plank. And then exhaling, bringing the hips up towards the sky. Bringing the weight of the heels onto the mat. Melting those heels. Perfect downward facing dog, Courtney. Pushing the hands away from you, pushing the mat away from you, bringing the shoulder blades up, heels up. Good. Now gently begin to walk the dog by melting the right heel as you bend your left knee, and then melting the left heel as you bend your right knee. Perfect. And just do that for a few breaths, gently, slowly, carefully. Do what feels good for you. Listen to your body. Good. Breathing into that, using the breath as life, as the pranayama, as they call it. Bringing life into the limbs of the body. And gently release the walk and just melt both heels onto your mat. Come onto your tiptoes and tiptoe to the front of the mat, coming into a forward fold. Gently and carefully inhale halfway up, straight back. Nice deep breath in, gaze forward, chest open. Good. Exhale, we're going to melt up over our legs, gently bending at the knees, allowing our torso to melt onto our thighs, coming down, the crown facing down, an inversion. Allow the blood flow to come into your crown and just surrender, right? It's almost like a rag doll. So you want to really allow your knees to bend as much as they need to support your weight, where the top part of your body can just really relax. Letting all the blood flow go to the crown. Taking deep breaths if you need to, exhaling out from the mouth. Placing the right elbow, the right hand on the left elbow and the left hand on the right elbow. Allow yourself to sway from side to side. Gently start to make your way up, rocking side to side as your spine straightens. Slowly and carefully take it to the top. And when you arrive, allow the shoulder blades to go all the way back, melting the hands. Placing the hands on the side of the hips, staying in a mountain pose, they call this, just nice and straight. Taking a deep breath in, exhaling all the way out. And gently, slowly begin to bring your arms up and over the head, reaching up towards the sky. Gently push those hips forward and come back into a standing position, straight spine. Good. We're going to come over to the left side by grabbing our right wrist with our left hand, twisting over to the left. Good. Come back up to center. Switch hands. The right hand grabs the left wrist. Grab and reach over to the right side. Coming back up to the center. Release the hands onto your hips. Here, you need to adjust your tippy toes, your heels. And now we're going to place our hips about, our feet about hip width apart and bring the right hip over to the right side, bring it back and bring it around. And just take this as gently as you need to. What's really good about this is that it's moving all the energy in our lower back and in our hips, down our legs. Inhaling as you go back, exhaling as you go forward. Pause with your hips forward and switch. Go over to the left. And over to the right, and forward. Again, you really want to make sure you're breathing into your hips for this one. You can let a lot of energy go. kind of rolling on that lower spine, massaging it. And just one more. And then we're gonna melt forward, wide legged forward fold this time. Again, bend your knees if you need to, but allow the chest to just melt through the legs, crown completely down. Nice deep breath in through your nose. Exhale, surrender, allowing the shoulders, the hands, everything to really relax. Coming home, bringing the heart against those legs, giving your entire body love, bringing the mind, the body, and the spirit to complete surrender. Softening the jaw and the muscles in the forehead, and just letting go. Allowing the blood flow to go down towards the crown. One more deep breath in. Now we're going to place our toes away from us, to bring our heels in just a little bit and actually melt the hips in between. And take this very slowly and gently. It's like an inversion, yes. Use your hands perfect to support you. And then from here, we're just gonna gently come back up. Bring our feet in for a regular forward fold. Exhale, all the way down. Inhale, halfway up. Inhale through the nose. Exhale from the mouth. Placing both hands on the mat, so bend your knees if you need to. We're going to go into our sun salutation, bringing the right leg straight back onto your toes for a runner's lunge. Good. Dropping the right knee. Yep, bringing the right knee right to the ground. Perfect. If it's okay. If not, bring both the left. Yeah. Perfect. And so coming into that runner's lunge. Inhale back up on to the right toes. Come up into a high plank. Good. We're going to chaturanga, which means bringing our knees, our elbows, our chest and our chin up into a downward facing dog. Good. Take a deep breath. Gaze up towards the sky. Exhale into a downward facing dog. Inhale, gaze up to the front of the mat. Walk the feet. Inhale, halfway up. Exhale all the way down. Inhale, gently rise up. All the way up. Arms above the head, hips forward, slight back bend. Exhale back into a forward fold. Different legs, so bring the left leg straight back for a runner's lunge. Nice and easy. Good. Keeping the right knee above the right ankle. Gently drop the left knee, relax your left toes. This is the forward fold, so you can push your hips just a little forward. Good, both hands firmly back on the mat, right, left toes on the mat, bring the right leg back, straight back for a high plank. Good, high plank, gently come into a chaturanga, bring the knees, the elbows, the chest, the chin, good job. Up into a down, upward facing dog. And now we're gonna come into a child's pose, bringing the hips onto the heels, toes together, nice wide stretch. Good, you can melt in between your knees. So opening up the knees about hip width apart. Beautiful, yes, melting the heart onto your mat, softening the fingertips, the wrist. Just allow yourself to release and let go of anything you're holding on to in the body or in the mind, and stay with your breath for a few moments. Breathing in, you feel the belly expanding against your legs. And then exhale, you just feel it contract, releasing all the way out, softening the forehead. You draw all the muscles down your spine, your hips, the elbows. And gently and slowly, carefully coming back up to a tabletop position. We're going to actually push the hips forward for one last upward facing dog. Get that lower back. Good. Coming back up on to our knees into that tabletop position. And then bringing the hips onto the heels. And see just how that feels. And then slowly just releasing your legs out in front of the body. That's impressive. How does that feel on your knees? Okay. Perfect. So now we'll just focus on our legs. You did great. Full body. With our legs, we'll extend the right leg, but bend the left knee. If this is okay. Yeah, perfect. And then we'll open up the left side, the right side of our body. Yep, perfect. Now we're gonna walk our fingers over to our right foot. Yep, and you can go like this or inhaling the left arm up. Seeing what feels good for you. You pretty much just want to stretch that leg. Yep. Allowing the chest to melt over the leg, giving it love, actually radiating love from your heart to your leg. Take one more deep breath. Walking the hands on the leg, bring it back up. Come back up to center. Slowly, carefully, beautiful. Let's see if we get a butterfly in the middle of each leg. Straightening the spine, coming onto our tailbone. Allowing the knees to fall deeper into the mat. And this is just a deep stretch for that inner thigh area, the groin. So breathe into that. And switch legs. So the right knee, the right leg stays back, and extend the left leg out. Perfect. Again, we welcome our left foot. We could either grab or place our hands on our shins or whatever it is that allows you to fully extend your torso on top of the left leg.
Calm down.
Gently, slowly, carefully coming back up to the center. Extending both legs out. Pointing the toes towards you. Now we'll melt over both legs, melting forward and then down. So perfect. Keeping that chest nice and open and then just growing. Yep, perfect. Falling deeper into it. Maybe grabbing the shins or the back of the foot. And you should feel this all the way from the lower back into the top of the crown. So allowing your crown to just relax. Gently, slowly, carefully bringing the spine back up straight. Bringing the hands down to the side of the mat. Towards the back of the body, allowing the shoulder blades to go back, opening up your chest, and just gently allow your neck to just go slightly back. And this is just going to be an inversion. This is one way to do it. Another way to do it is to gently bring your hips off the mat. Totally optional. It just allows for you to get some arm strength in there. One more deep breath. Great job. Exhale, slowly bring it down. Good work. Coming back up. Now to deepen the leg stretch, let's bring our right knee into our chest. Perfect. Wherever she wants to go, as long as it's comfortable, you want to kind of keep your spine straight, chest up against the right leg, bringing the left shoulder, left elbow around the right knee. Right arm goes up. Exhale, twist up over the shoulder. Slowly, gently release back to center. Switch legs, allowing the right leg to go all the way out. Placing the right elbow on the left knee, twisting the torso against the left leg. Right arm, left arm up. Exhale back. And gaze up and over. The left arm. And slowly come back to center. Both knees in. And I've been doing this lately that really helps my lower back. I want to show you and see how you feel about it. And see if it's something you want to try. But I rock, so I keep my knees bent, but I rock on my lower back, and then I kick those legs forward. Perfect. And I do this a few times. It's kind of fun and playful, but also massages the spine. So let's just do one more inhaling back. Exhaling forward. Good. And then we're just going to bend those knees in. Keep them bent. Come onto our lower back. Now we're going to go into a supine, which is when you bend both knees over to the left side of the body. Keep them a few inches off the mat if you can. And keep your right shoulder on the mat. Extend the right arm, gaze towards your fingertips. Hold. Deep breath in. Exhale out. Deep breath in. Exhale out. One more. Inhale in. Exhale out. Come back to center. Drop both knees over the right side. Extend the left arm completely out. Deep breath in. Exhale out. Both knees into your chest. And now just go side to side with the knees, just like a windshield wiper. Massaging your lower back. And you can go from windshield wiping side to side to creating a circle. Pause and then go the opposite direction. Perfect. Bring both knees into your chest. Extend both legs up towards the sky. The soles of the feet towards the sky. Here, feel free to move your toes. Wiggle them. Rotate your ankles in both directions. Feel the elbows and the chest and everything just relaxed onto the mat. And now bending your knees, bring each knee into the rib cage. And grabbing either your shins or the bottom of your feet. Come into your happy baby, breathing into your belly, taking your time to fully extend your belly. Exhale all the way out, belly contracts. Maybe you rock side to side. Perfect. And then release the hands. Gently bring the soles of the feet together in front of you for a butterfly. This time laying on your back. Good. So maybe placing your hands either on the inner thigh. Releasing if you need to rearrange your back just to get comfortable. Tucking the jaw just a little bit. Just become present with the breath, the life source energy that's flowing through you. Now place one hand on your heart, one hand on your belly. Completely just surrender. Bringing both knees in carefully, gently together. Bringing the heels of the feet close to the body, reaching for your fingertips towards your heels. Deep breath in. We lift our hips just gently off the mat. Good. For a bridge pose. And now depending how deep you'd like to go, you can bring the shoulder blades together underneath you and interlace the fingers, keeping the knees close as if there was a block between them that you would be squeezing. Engaging those glutes, reaching with those hips up to the sky. Using the shoulders to support you. Beautiful. Breathing into the belly.
And slowly releasing the arms out to the sides of the body. Exhale down. Bring the knees into your chest. Bring your forehead up to your knees. Give yourself a great big hug because you really deserve it. Squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. And gently go out into your Shavasana, bringing the left heel to the right side of the mat.
Yes, perfect. Allowing both legs to fall heavy. And allowing the hands to be on the sides of the body, palms facing up towards the sky. Relaxing the entire body. From your toes, all around the feet, your ankles, the shins, the front and the back of the lower leg, your knees, the front and the back, the inner and outer thigh, your hips, the muscles and the belly, all around your core. Each one softens with ease. The chest, the muscles all around your heart center, your shoulders, your elbows, the wrist and the fingers, all five fingers on each hand. Your neck, the jaw unclenching, softening, the tongue muscle, all around the nose, your eyes, your forehead, all the way up to the scalp, and releasing, relaxing every muscle. With ease, just gently breathe in your Shavasana for a few minutes, allowing the practice to integrate in the body. And gently bringing the awareness back to the physical body, taking a deep breath in to expand your body, exhaling all the way out. gently beginning to move and wiggle the toes, the fingers, your wrist and your ankles, rotating in one direction and then the other. Gently and carefully extending your arms up over your head. Nice long stretch from your fingers all the way to your toes. Good. Perfect. Now bringing the arms back towards the sides of the body and coming into a fetal position. Just slowly moving on to the side. Perfect. Just take a few breaths here, a few moments. Give yourself that love that you deserve. Gently extending the leg that's on the top out straight, placing the inner foot onto your mat. Good. And then placing the arm that's on the top, place the palm down on the mat, and just gently and carefully using both extremities to walk your way up to a seated position, back to where we started, but in a new way. And gently, you can keep your eyes closed. We'll meet here as you arrive. Just gently observe how you're feeling now versus the beginning of class. Observe the intention that you had on your heart. And now we release it. And as we let go, with faith that it will all happen for us, and gently arrive back to a meditative state, a nice clear mind, focusing on your breath, extending with your inhale and contracting, releasing, letting go on that exhale. Just observing the breath. We're going to place our palms together, create some warmth. And with our warm palms, we're going to place them on a specific area on our body that needs some extra love. So whether it's your knees, your heart, your mind, your eyes, just allowing this warm energy to pulsate right through our bodies. And feel the energy flowing from your hands into the body. Nice deep breath all the way in. Exhale, release. The hands come to the front of our head. We bow to all that is wonderful, to all that is good, to all that is us and beyond us, with gratitude for this practice, for showing up today. Namaste. Thank you. practicing today was so special. I really needed this. It was really, really divine.
It was. Thank you so much. I also needed that.
Oh, good. I felt the energy, definitely. It was very divine feminine and just good surrender, letting go. Thank you so much. I wanted to actually leave Shavasana longer because I'm like, you look so peaceful, but I wanted to respect your time too. So if you want to take back to it, you can absolutely, you know, always rest in Shavasana. It's a really great way for your body to regenerate because there's less pressure. We're not putting any weight on our legs or, you know, standing or sitting. It's just a good way to kind of set the body in a space where your cells can move freely and really operate without all that weight. So
nice.
Yes. You have a beautiful day, Courtney. So great. This talk made my day.
Me too.
Good. I love that we can do this. I really look forward to them. It's so nice to be here and slow down.
Yes, definitely.
Thank you for showing up. I hope you have a beautiful night and a good rest of your week. That the breath can carry you through anything that comes your way that you can overcome.
Yes. Thank Hold you.
Yes. Always a pleasure. I'll see you in 2 weeks.
Okay. Good night.
Good night. Take care. You too.
You too.
Bye.